dragonseeds, with many dozens of Targaryen bastards trying to claim the unclaimed dragons and many deaths that occurred due to this event. The ending of it saw a visible shift in the balance of power between the Blacks and the Greens, with the previously unclaimed Targaryen dragons Vermithor and Silverwing now ridden by Hugh Hammer and Ulf White, respectively. These two dragons were large and old, each being half the age of Vhagar, and with Vermithor alone being almost as large as the Green Death dragons to assert their dominance over the skies, sending Silverwing and Ulf White to soar over King's Landing in a display of sheer might and defiance against the Green faction, but mainly against Aemond and his dragon Vhagar. The scene was beautiful. It was the first time a dragon, lest there was incitement of the common folk of the capital city to further tilt to Rhaenyra's cause and therefore rioting even more. Aemond Targaryen, with his tempestuous nature and rageful attitude, could not ignore such a provocation, especially done in front of his small council members. As he was the king regent now, it was like an insult right to his face. His eyes blazed with fury of a thousand suns as he watched Silverwing's majestic form cut through the skies, passing right by the Red Keep. He immediately took to horseback to get to his dragon that was parked outside the city due to her gigantic size not fitting inside the dragon pit anymore. He knew that Vhagar, the ancient and powerful dragon from the Conquest and a survivor of 100 battles, could easily defeat Silverwing, though the battle against melees in Rook's Rest had proven to be a formidable challenge and was eventually won by cunning. Even so, Aemond's confidence was unshaken. He believed that he could vanquish Silverwing easily, since the new rider lacked experience, and if it came to it, he could also do away with Syrax as well, although the risk would be higher. Until recently, Dragonstone, the Black Stronghold, was under the deterrence of Syrax and the smaller dragons Vermax and Moondancer. Aemond knew that he had to be cautious to avoid an ambush while planning his raid in the foreseeable future. His position as King Regent demanded decisive action, yet he was mindful of the perils if he was to lay siege to the Dragonstone with his large dragon. Although he was confident the dragon could take on Syrax and the smaller ones, the added air defense of Dragonstone with its own ballistas and scorpion bolts deterred him from taking action. Also, he is currently the King Regent and had to oversee the military maneuvers, as well as him being obsessed with Harrenhal and Daemon with Caraxes there. And in addition to this, he did not realize that Adam of Hull had claimed Sea Smoke, or rather the other way around, which adds to the Black's aerial power. The lack of knowledge was on purpose due to Larys Strong keeping the sensitive information a secret for his hate of Aemond and his desire to see him gone or killed. So driven by rage and a desire to crush the spirit of the Blacks, Aemond decided to pursue Silverwing, hoping to catch her and her rider Ulf White unawares midway during their return to Dragonstone. As Vhagar took swiftly to flight in order to catch up with Silverwing, quickly passing over the Blackwater Bay and approaching Dragonstone itself, Aemond realized something was amiss. It was during this pursuit that Aemond's blood ran cold. The enormous dragon Vermithor loomed into view, a dragon nearly as large and even fiercer than Vhagar herself, now claimed by Hugh Hammer. Vermithor had been the dragon of King Jaehaerys Targaryen, the Old King, and throughout his long half a century reign as king, with the Bronze Fury by his side, no would-be challenger or usurper would ever be seen. He was the reason Aemond and Vhagar fled the scene. This was clear right after when he realized his folly and spoke to Vhagar to flee and turn around in High Valyrian. The scene immediately shifts to Rhaenyra walking with Vermithor in the background. Panic surged through Aemond as the realization dawned upon him, for even just a one-on-one battle against Vermithor would likely result in mutual destruction for both dragons and their riders. And with the large female dragon Silverwing and Syrax along with the smaller dragons Moondancer as well as Vermax converging upon him, the odds would be insurmountable. Not to mention that Sea Smoke, a dragon that is fully grown now, was also in their retinue. Vhagar, despite her immense power, could and would not secure aerial supremacy against such overwhelming odds. She has size, but so do the Blacks now with Vermithor, and they had the numbers, as well as speed. With a sharp command, Aemond urged Vhagar to flee. The ancient dragon responded, her massive wings propelling them away from the imminent threat. So Rhaenyra and her Black faction had done what was once thought impossible, to swiftly secure the unclaimed dragons by employing Targaryen bastards. and she had almost orchestrated the trap masterfully. Although with them standing there, roaring instead of taking flight, it was more evident of a show of force. This left the King Regent Aemond with no choice but to retreat, with his thoughts of retribution and decisive action successfully thwarted by the sheer might of their united dragon force. And so here, the real reason why he fled Dragonstone was not because of the more numerous dragons, but because Vermithor was also present in the scene, a Castle Bravo hydrogen bomb deterrence to his own Tsar bomber, that is Vhagar. And with that, we come to the end of this video. Now, if you like this one, then watch this one too, and do check out our channel for other dragon and monster content. We might just have things you haven't seen before. Like, subscribe, and we'll see you in the next video. Take care, guys.